We have seen very wonderful circuits in AC circuit chapter. Today we will see another special circuit in the AC. Whenever we are receiving a large number of electromagnetic waves, or we are getting a large number of signals in the form of AC current, which are having different frequencies. So, one AC circuit help us to select one signal out of many signals. We call that circuit as selector circuit, and that consists of L, C, R in series that reject all the other frequencies and select one, and the process is known as tuning, that we did in the tuning circuit. Now, again, from a music, we are receiving so many signals, one for the singer, one for the drummer, one for the violin, one for sitar, and like that, so many signals are coming to us. Each signal is belonging to a particular frequency. It's having a particular frequency. That means there are voltages, there are electric fields oscillating with different frequencies which are coming to our machine, which are coming to our amplifier or whatever circuit we are using. Now, so many signals are coming amplified from the speaker, we get the sound and we listen to it. Out of that, we want to reject one particular sound which has got a particular frequency. We want that sound or that signal should stop, that should be filtered out, and rest all the frequencies should come as it is. So it is a reverse job of selector circuit. In selector, we reject all, select one. In this circuit, I will call it a filter circuit. We reject one frequency and select all others to come. This is action of filter. Again, this can be done by same components L, C and R. R has not much participation in this, like oscillations, and L and C, they play very important role. This circuit is made by fitting parallel L and C, inductor and capacitor. And they will filter out one particular current which has got one particular frequency. How they do it, let us see. So, here we are supplying the current which is coming to our circuit. On the way, we cut it and fit this circuit. What is this? LC parallel circuit. Now the current E naught sin omega t, this EMF is applied between any two points, and I is equal to I naught sin omega t. This is the current flowing through this line. Now from here, these are the two points and these are in parallel. So we know at any instant, potential difference between the two will be same for this as well as for this. And what is distributed? Answer, current is distributed. Okay, so current is distributed from here. One part of the current goes here, one goes here. Now, this total current I, it has two parts, one IL and one IC, which is passing through capacitor. IL and IC, these are the two currents passing. Again, they combine, become IC and go there. Okay. Now, this IL and IC, the maximum value of I here is I naught. Here, the maximum value is I naught through L, and here, the maximum value is I naught through capacitor. Now, at any instant IL, at any instant IC is the component of current at any instant I, and that is written in this equation. Now, this IL we can write as I naught sin omega t minus pi by 2, and this we can write I naught sine omega t plus y2, because this current is always advanced pi by 2 and this always retard pi by 2. Okay, so this I is divided into these two parts. Now this is maximum current through inductor, peak current of the inductor, and this peak current can be written as potential difference divided by XL, and the potential difference here is E naught. So E naught upon XL replaces this. Here E naught upon XC replaces this. Rest remains same. Now in these two, E naught is common. Okay, we will take it out later. First, this trigonometric function sine omega t minus pi by 2 is equal to, reverse this, pi by 2 minus omega t, and there will be a minus here, minus. But sine pi by 2 minus omega t is equal to cos omega t, with that minus. So it is converted to this expression, and here sine pi by 2 plus omega t is again cos omega t. So it is converted to this expression. Now you see E naught cos omega t is a common factor of the two, E naught cos omega t, and what we have inside, I will write the positive term first, 1 upon xc minus 1 upon xl. So this is simplified equation for the current, this current which is passing through and coming here. Now we want to make this current zero. We want to filter out this current. So to filter, this should become zero. And how this will become zero? This will become zero if this one component is zero. Cos omega t will not be zero because that is a fluctuating term. This, if it is 0, this I will be permanently 0. So to filter, I is equal to 0, 1 upon XL and 1 upon XC, they should be equal to each other. 1 upon XL and 1 upon XC, they should be equal to each other. If this is the condition, we can expand this condition. 1 upon L omega is equal to XC is 1 upon C omega. So this is C omega upon 1. And this gives us omega is equal to 1 upon root LC. This we have done number of times. This is the condition for filtering and making I is equal to 0. That means if we choose this L and C with certain particular values such that this equation is satisfied. Omega is the frequency of that particular current. Suppose, okay, that particular current, then that current will become 0, and if that current is 0, we do not see its effect. It is just like this, you have seen karaoke. In karaoke what happens? There are music of all the instruments and a person who is singing, that is our original set. Out of that, the voice of the singing person, the voice of the singer is omitted. Rest every, all currents are there except the singer's voice. Now what happens? Singer has a particular frequency. Like I am speaking to you, the frequency of my voice is around 200. So if you apply a filter that we do not want a frequency 150 to 300, then you will listen all other sounds except my voice. That will be filtered out. The same thing we do. We choose C and L in such a way that this comes to be 2 pi into 200, and 200 is the frequency of that person. Now what will happen? This particular current which is carrying singer's voice become 0, and rest all the currents are coming as it is. So you listen all the music of the sound minus sound of the singer, and then you use it for karaoke. This is technology of making karaoke, and you can make it in your computer with a simple software that can be done. Okay, so the purpose is, this is the circuit and this particular frequency can be filtered out. This is also known as filter circuit, and normally we use it for suppressing noise. If there is a scratch noise which is disturbing us in an old song, so we make a filter that this frequency is not allowed. The frequency to which that scratch noise consists of. So that frequency will be filtered out, rest of the music will come, that scratch noise will not come. So that's why it's a very important one. Now, if we get the frequency response and we make a graph like this. This particular frequency, omega naught, other frequencies will have certain, yes, they will have certain value, I. This frequency, of course, all these frequencies will have I, but this frequency, particular frequency, for this I is almost equal to zero. So this is filtered out. This is all about filter circuit. Thank you.